Okay, so in this case I have two wireless interfaces. One is 2 gigahertz frequency, the other one is 5 gigahertz frequency. Now let's get into one of the interfaces. For you to create your access list, normally if you come to the wireless interface, you have these two enabled by default. Okay, you have these two enabled by default. So in this case, I'm going to disable this default forward. And the reason why I'm disabling it, the default forward is, before I proceed with this, I'm actually not using Mikrotik to connect to this other Mikrotik device. I'm going to use this my mobile phone. So this is going to connect to, I'm going to add this mobile phone to my access list. Okay, and then we will know and understand how it works. So let's proceed. So if I disable the default authentication or default authenticate, it's actually not going to. It means the wireless authentication I've configured on my Mikrotik right now, it's not going to work with the access list I'm going to create. That's if I disable default authenticate, right? So I'll do the same thing with the second wireless interface as well. Okay. So let's come to grade. So under access list, you can actually add the MAC address of the device you want to be added as the access list. Okay, so this is where you add the MAC address. If you know the MAC address, you put it here. But if you don't want to go through this header, simply come to registration and locate the device, the device's MAC address, and then you can add straight from this part of it. And this is what makes me like Mikrotik so much. And so we are going to use this, the MAC address of my mobile phone, for the access list. And so this is my MAC address. Right click on it and then connect to asset, copy to access list. Okay, so when that is done, you are not going to see the MAC address listed under registration. Come back to access list and double click and open it. This is the MAC address of my mobile phone. Now you can go ahead and change the interface if you want to change it. You can change the signal strength range. You can change the allow signal out of range. The AP transmit limit. You can also configure it here. You can also configure the client TX limit from here. Okay. But then, if nothing to be done, just leave it at default. And then click on disable the authentication, which means this my access list control is not going to use the default authentication I have on my router. Okay, when you disable this, you can actually configure a password individually for this client or MAC address, which means this MAC address or this access point or this mobile phone connected to Mikrotik is only going to use this password to connect to my Wi-Fi or network, and which is also part of the access list MAC addresses. Okay, so we choose, this is the password we've configured here, and then you can go further and then actually indicate the times this access list should work on this MAC address. So we can decide that maybe from 8 a.m. okay, let's say one day, so 8 a.m. to perhaps 10 p.m. is 10. So we've come to the end of this video. Thank you for having the time to watch this video, and I understand that you know how access list actually works in Mikrotik and therefore most other brands as well. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to share my videos, like my videos, and comment on my videos as well. Thank you very much for watching. Please, I'll be coming up with a video on connect list. So please stay tuned on this page. Thank you.